are listening to Alpha Geek Radio.
The following is a Black Swamp Studio production.
Welcome to show number 113 of the Your Wow Money Podcast. I am the Kerosene Kid, and with me is Miss Lady Hava. Hello, my dear.
Hey, guys. How's it going today, Kiro?
We are doing just fine today. Just sitting right out here in front of Ogimar. But somebody else isn't here, namely, it's Reckles. How's it going, buddy?
I am good. I'm coming. I'm on my way.
He's on his way.
I couldn't remember which server my horn tune, my one horn tune was on.
Oh boy!
I wanted to show up in the best geared tune possible, and
sorry, the best geared here today is me.
Well, that is
you
true.
All finally get to see my transmogs and.
Go transmog this tune real quick.
Happy gear.
I'm gonna go do that. Oh, cause I have gold. I can go transmog before I meet up with y'all.
In my wonderful new model I've been waiting for forever.
Uh-huh.
That I'm now more curves than angles. It makes me so happy.
It does.
Check this out. This is Holy Hava in her white and gold.
And it's not blue and black.
This is my raiding set. No. But I get a little more dangerous for PvP. You ready for this?
Okay.
Oh, hell yeah.
Uh-oh.
There you go. There's the PvP set.
Oh, boy. There we go.
Very dangerous. She looks kick-ass. It's like, here, I'm still going to heal you during battle. It's just going to be a little more ferocious. PvP set. Holy set.
Okay. There we go. Okay. I love new stuff.
I'm just saying.
Anyway.
It's time for progressions.
All right, so who wants to go first?
I'll go first.
Okay. Go for it.
So, better late than never. Of course, we've downed Grull on heroic, and we're progressed through normal up to Iron Maidens, but the maidens are being not too friendly ladies. You can use your choice of terms there. Hey, look who's here! Man, I got two big
buzz
on the other side of me.
There he is.
So we banged our head against maidens all Thursday evening. Best attempt was like 13%. But it's just got to click. You know how those fights go when they're all mechanics fights and people have to just not die to the mechanics and stay alive. And as soon as we get that to click for everybody, then we'll be good to go. With that, though, I haven't gotten any new gear drops other than what we can make myself. So my arm guards, I finally recrafted those and got them level 4 of 4. And my shoulders, level 4 of 4. That's got my eye level up to 676 right now because I haven't had any new missions. So.
Yeah, I hear you there. All right.
On the pet side, I've gotten one other new pet because I got all of my raiding with leashes, you know, last week. I've picked up my young Talbot from the Traveler. So still waiting the Slither Shock Eel and the Sea Calf. Of course, we can't get the Race Mini Zep yet, but I'm on track to get that next Dark Moon Fair, and the Bone Serpent. So just waiting to get those, and I'll be back on track with fun stuff.
Excellent, excellent. So I was on the Converted Podcast today.
Woohoo!
And with being on the Converted, or not today, but last Monday, I'm sorry. But with that, we do have permission to air some of the audio that we recorded on Monday night. And this is really good for beginner stuff. But we'll get to that here later. Outside of that, I've been just doing some Garrison stuff and going back and forth between Mist and here. Just saying that the song bells, although the Motes of Harmony and Spirits of Harmony have been selling for pretty good prices. In fact, I just made about $2,000 today on Airy Peak.
Yeah, because there have been none up at all.
Yep. So just selling there. And really, that's all I've been doing. I've been kind of messing around with other things. And it's just a really fun stuff. Anyway, if you want to watch the whole Converted Podcast, which did have some really good stuff, it is up on youtube.com/ConvertedPodcast, and you want to see episode 52, or you can find them on iTunes and Stitcher. Just look for a Converted Podcast, and that was show number 52. But Ruckles, what have you been doing this week?
Well,
he's a plant, by the way.
I am planted because I have been playing with. Actually, no, I just found this thing in my bags, and I thought it would be fun. But now I can't. I haven't played this tune. I can't unplant. Help! Oh no! I can't unplant.
Oh no! You can't unplant. Oh no!
What am I gonna do? This is the most exciting thing in the world to watch. Okay, so summon. Can I at least summon a pet? I can't. Okay, so mentioning pets, I have been having a lot of fun with pet battles and doing guides and setting up guides for all of the pet battle things on Want to Buy Gold Blue. Just kind of catching up on all the more recent stuff so I can get to some of the more fun older guides that people have kind of forgotten about. Because, back in the old, back in Mist of Pandaria, it was, how do you two-pet this? People weren't really concerned about soloing it, and that's what I'm focusing on. I'm like, there has to be a pet. We have so many pets now. There is a pet that you can solo everything, and I'm starting to see that there are 4 or 5 pets that you can solo pretty much every team with. It's really cool to spend a couple hours on each fight and see that, mm-hmm. you can do it with this setup, if you just get creative. So I have, I didn't have enough pets, so I went out there, and this week I leveled up, I think, at least one tune. I leveled to 100, and I got, I think, 35 pets to level 25.
Right.
Yeah, guys, you all have to realize that after last week's podcast, me and Reckles stayed talking for nearly a half an hour going over lists of pets that would be ideal to get leveled.
Oh, and I am officially the best pet battler of the week.
God, here we go.
I am the grand champion of the tournament. We had a tournament
against
and I won.
Well, I guess we got to do it again. I call rematch.
Yeah. Rematch this week. And this week. If y'all want to be involved in the tournament, then come meet us live and we'll have a tournament every week and the winner will be announced. But so far, I have the crown. I grinded out about 35 pets, so hopefully I'll be able to give better guides with more popular pets that, you know, hey, if you have a shrine fly, you can solo this boss, you know, things like that, rather than, you know, little Ragnaros, which not everyone has. So, did that also... this is kind of news, but, since it's not World of Warcraft, I wanted to put it in here. I've been doing a lot of Heroes of the Storm, and they went to PAX East.
Yes, they did.
And they have some really cool stuff that they're doing. They're introducing a new patch where they've got Sylvanas. They're introducing a new hero, Sylvanas, and she's awesome. You know, she doesn't like the Lich King, and you can control enemy minions and turn, like, if a hero is coming at you, you can control them and turn them, and you can control minions, and it's crazy, and a new battleground, all that good stuff. But also, if you are in college... they are giving out a $25,000 per year college scholarship to 5 people who form a team and compete. So that's awesome. If you're in college, freaking form a team, play Brightwing, Vala, Nazebo, and Stitches, and go wreck the game and win. And also... I think I contributed to the game because I said, hey, I put a post up on the forum saying that, hey, it would be nice if there was more detailed statistics afterwards, and a bunch of people liked the post and commented on it, and we now have more detailed statistics after the game, and that's great. So, yay for Blizzard continuing to listen during beta. I like Blizzard and their feedback system during beta. It's nice.
I think my Gazrookie's hungry.
That's what I did. And I'm still a plant.
You gotta go eat the Reckles plant.
Yes.
I might switch to my Horde barking tune just so I'm not a plant. I don't know how to get out of this.
No.
Wait.
Click on your buff.
The buff.
No, I can't see the debuff because there's an add-on in the way.
Move the add-on.
Oh, that's your own fault.
I can't move the add-on. I'm going to
log out.
Log out. There we go. Dang it.
Pet battle teams disable. There. Wait. Pet battle. There.
Now see.
Reload you up.
Now hold on. That's why I have this add-on control panel. At which people in the Twitch chat can see. Because then I can just click on anything that I want to have up. And anything I don't want to have up, I can just uncheck mark. That's what I love about that add-on control panel. Anyway, since we are done, and like we said, there's like very little news, we are going right into the classroom. And this is going to have a lot of the converted podcast audio in it. So with that, we will get to hear the voices of and I got to pull up the page. Samakis, if I got her name right. Belschnickel, which he is the host, and Navox. And they are all Alliance side. So here we go.
Now it's time for the classroom. Advice on making gold via the auction house, professions, and more.
Hey, there's Ruckles. All right, so the first question is, came from Belschnickel, and they wanted to know how to get started making gold.
All right, listen, Kerosene Kid. All right, I'm a regular player, man. I'm playing some WoW. I'm broke. All right, I'm poor. I need some gold. Like, where do you start? Like, what do you recommend people start to kind of get their hands around some money? You know, I mean, that's what we need. You know, help us out. Like, what's the some tips for the early broke poor person in WoW?
Well, for the early like really broke people, everybody's got a mine. Everybody's got an herb garden.
Okay.
So start there, because a lot of that stuff is being really fluid right now, especially frostweed. And
okay.
I got to tell you a little something earlier today. On this realm, Airy Peak, I sold, I think, about 110 stacks of 10 of frostweed, and they all sold within 2 minutes.
Okay.
Wow.
Wow.
So
this
is
your alchemy.
Oh, yeah. Alchemy is huge, especially when you're making the 680 trinkets right now.
Okay.
So
you recommend alchemy as a profession, right? That's a good place to start?
That would be an okay place to start. I think anything crafting right now would be a decent place. But gathering, for major starting, gathering is the place to start right now, mm-hmm. just for starters.
Very time-consuming, though, right? I mean, that takes, you know...
It can be, but there's a trick to mining right now.
Okay.
If you have the mining pick, or the peon's mining pick, and you have the miner's, the green one that's consumable...
Mm-hmm. The coffee and the miner's pick and all that?
Yes. You can mine ore within under a second.
Ooh. What?
So it goes insanely fast.
Okay.
I was doing it today.
All right.
And... But it's only in your garrison in the mine, so.
Okay, so you get the consumable one that you get from the carts, right? And,
right.
And then what's the other one? The other pick?
The peon's mining pick that is found in the spires of Arrak. And it's right around Admiral Taylor's garrison in that area. So if you can find that and you combine that with the carts, it's a lot of ore in very quick time.
Okay.
Wow.
Okay.
So, what do you guys think? What would be a good place to start making gold? In your mind. What do you think, Rickle? Or what do you think, Abba?
I want to back that back, because you're talking about starting to make gold in your garrison.
Right.
That means you've already hit level 90, 92 to open your mine, you know. Back it up even more. You know, they kind of took it from there and went. But I don't want people to forget or to underestimate using mining on the old world stuff. Tin ore, for example, is selling right now for a gold 70. Tin, you know. Imagine just taking an hour a day to go do that. Now, when you get up to your garrison, yeah, mining is good because it's fast and that stuff is selling decently. But my biggest money maker right now is the fish. You know, if you're just going to be doing other things and sitting around... sea scorpid segments. You get 20 of those when you combine 5 enormous sea scorpids. So you figure if you're using a bait, that's 5 casts. You get 20 sea scorpid segments, and they're selling for 4 gold 37 each right now on Earthenring. That's pretty profitable. That's, you know, 80 gold a stack. 80 gold per 20, 80 gold per 5 times, you know, of your standard fishing cast. You know, you farm up those pretty easily. Pretty time efficiently right now. And in the meantime, you're looking at the chance of getting Nat's Lucky Coins. You
right.
can be working on your Nat achievement. You could be, you know, turning those into foods and selling the foods. I don't know how profitable the difference is between the raw meat and the foods right now. But Sea Scorpid, Fat Sleeper Flesh, Abyssal Gulper Eel, those are all really popular foods, so...
Those are all good points. What do you think, Reckles?
I like starting with gathering professions on a new tune. It's just a good way to learn the auction house with, because you don't have to worry about crafting and buying and like, especially with the warlords, where okay, you've got your daily cooldown and how many daily cooldowns, and then I've got to do this secrets to buy the plans to get this, and then I've got to upgrade this three times in order to craft something that'll actually sell to make me a profit. Like, it's the crafting professions can get kind of complicated, whereas, or you can just go out there into the open world, mine, you can mine old stuff like Elementium ore or Ghost Iron ore, or, you know, even the current world mats, Blackrock ore, True Iron ore, and then just wait for it to be an ore trader day. Would be my biggest tip. Just mine a whole bunch of stuff in your garrison in the open world, and then wait for the garrison trader to be that profession's, you know, wait for that to be the ore trader, and then sell all of your stuff for obscene prices. Other than that, I think glyphs used to be kind of advanced. Glyphs have become less work now,
right.
Since you can learn everything as you're making them. I like the changes they made to Inscription, so I wouldn't hesitate a new person. I wouldn't hesitate from saying, "Hey, new people, make an Inscriptionist. Just be careful of the bag space that it's going to take up, because you still will be posting 400 items when you repost a full." Crafting schedule.
Well, they're all good points, because you can really start anywhere anymore. And you're right about I think you're right about Inscription, you know, because things did get dumbed down quite a bit. Anyway. Oh, go ahead.
Well, I do love the transmog market, and like the transmog
right.
and the pet market, I both kind of put together in the same category of like going out and farming things. And like that in the, that's kind of the most outside of flipping is, you know, flipping on the auction house is the best way to make gold in the long run, but that's where it gets complicated, and that's where it gets kind of more advanced. But going out and farming for transmog and pets is where you can get a lot of gold, and I would recommend that for new people to start, like, just pick a dungeon that you liked from your leveling process or that you think looked cool from a video you saw once, and go out there and run it and see if you get anything cool. Put it on the auction house for, you know, download Trade Skill Master and put it up for the global median.
Very, very good. Very good. Now we get into whitelisting people and blacklisting people.
I was going to ask you real quick, do you have any serious competitors out there? I mean, like, do you got anybody that you battle with on a regular basis? Because, I mean, you're not the only person doing this, so, you know, or is it pretty friendly? I mean, what's going down? Is it getting down and dirty or what? You don't have to throw any names out, you know, if you want to keep it low-key, but, you know what I mean, like...
Right, exactly. And the thing is, when you have your real ID, mm-hmm. and you tend to give out your real ID to people, and they're on, like, the same realm, you do want to play nice with everybody. Mm-hmm. So the mm-hmm. way I have my auctionator set up, I have it set up so where I undercut everybody by one copper.
Okay.
What that does is it prevents a lot of people from getting mad at you.
Right, for dropping it heavy.
That auction house from dropping in prices severely.
Okay.
So that's smart. I do try to play nice.
Another thing I know that some auction house players will do what do they call it, like, whitelist people? So that there's certain people that they won't undercut, like their friends.
Right, right. And that is kind of a thing there, too, because, you, like I said, you don't want to make people mad. So mm-hmm. to have them whitelisted, you know, is a good thing. I don't tend to whitelist people because I'll be whitelisting everybody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But mm-hmm. if I had another account, then I would blacklist everybody and play this down and dirty.
Down and dirty, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Like, straight up cutthroat style. Yeah. I like it. Yeah, you know, man, you got to play to win, Kerosene. You got to play to win. You know what I'm saying?
You do. You absolutely have to play to win this, because the way the prices have been bouncing all around, and I've been kind of been aggravated about the garrisons, but I kind of love the garrisons myself. So mm-hmm. it's more what's going on right now.
Mm-hmm.
Ruckles, what do you think about whitelisting and blacklisting people?
Whitelisting's fun. Cartels are fun.
yes,
so
they
whitelisting,
are.
Whitelisting is something I recommend 95% of the time that you don't do. If someone says, hey, can you whitelist me? Just say, no thanks. And just don't. Just don't do it. Undercut them. Like, the only time you should whitelist someone is, if it's, Tradeskill Master automatically will not undercut your own tunes, but it will, the only time you want to whitelist people is if you've got, like, four main players on your auction house in a specific market, and the three of the main players control everything in a bunch of markets, and you're trying to drive out one of the people, and those three main players are all friends and talking, and you want to, like, whitelist each other, and you all have an agreement, and you're talking, and you're doing something that would be completely illegal in the United States if, like, so you whitelist each other and you set prices, and you set prices really high, and, like, so if you do that, then whitelist. So you can set prices where you want, and you don't undercut, and you don't change where your price is going to be. But other than that, don't whitelist.
What do you think, Hava?
I do not whitelist. I love my friends. My friends love me. They know what markets I'm posting in. We talk about it, you know? oh, guess what buy I just got today, blah, 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 blah. They're going, okay, I'm not going to put up any of that right now because I know you're going to just completely put it up. I'm like, you're right. I'm going to give them a heads up. Hey, I'm going to flip this market, you know. For the most part, you know, they know I stick to the realm of pets. So, I mean, one of them may get a pet drop that I've already got up. We just kind of watch out for each other just to see, well, oh, well, this person has that exact same pet up. I'll hold on to mine for like a week. I'm not necessarily going to whitelist them, but maybe I'm going to wait until the supply changes a little bit. You know, oh, there's no more of that particular pet up on Earth and Ring. Now I'm going to put it up. That's more watching the trend in the market, not whitelisting. You know, I don't see any point of whitelisting as far as the guild goes. I mean, being in a large guild like this, we're constantly, you know, posting over each other, especially when it comes to the vendor pets. There are a few guildies who attempt to compete with me on a regular basis, and
they lose.
More power to them. I think we all end up making some money. Maybe I'm not making all the money, but I'm making enough.
I gotcha. I know both sides of the argument, and I'm going to say whatever works for the people is what's going to work for the people. That's all I'm going to say.
Okay. So, let me ask you this. So, somebody starting out right now, somebody just picked up WoW, they got the 100, they're like, hey, I want to play the auction house, I want to make some gold.
This is about give add-ons, us, like, by the way.
Give us a couple tips for add-ons, websites that you use, things like that, to go do some research, and like maybe some do's and don'ts, like some quick down-and-dirty auction house tips.
If you're just starting out, I would not recommend getting TSM right now, okay. Because TSM is just a huge, massive deal that can be quite confusing and just quite insane. What I use for beginners is I use Auctionator.
What's TSM? What's TSM?
It's Skillmaster. Yes. And it
so Auctionator. Covers.
But yeah, I use Auctionator and I use it mainly for my posting. And what Auctionator does, it'll give you a list of whatever you want to see. Like right now I got Savage Blood pulled up. Mm-hmm. And right now I'm seeing a whole list from 474 up to about 500 and, or I'm sorry, 1,450, which that won't sell. But anyway, from 474 up to 1,000, and it gives you a good range of what you can buy. And if I go over to sell, I can just drag something into the auction house and just post it, you know, right away.
Okay.
Without any problems.
Is the auctioneer one, like, so. I think it's the auction. There was two auction add-ons,
There's Auctioneer. There's Auctionator.
Because I use Auctioneer, I think, TSM, but I've used it forever. Is that like obsolete now, or what?
Auctioneer is not really obsolete, but I kind of use something that's more simple. Because right now Auctioneer is kind of trying to get to this big massive thing like TSM is right now.
Okay. Oh, okay.
So, you know, using something that is a lot easier to navigate like Auctionator is really, really a good thing. Now, I also have a tool tip, and I got to pull this up here real quick just so I got the name right. It is the Undermine Journal for a tool tip. Now, if you go to theundermindjournal.com, you can use that website for anything, any research that you want to do for it. But they also have a tool tip, so...
In-game.
I thought the Undermine Journal went away.
It did for a while, Sal.
It did for a while.
Oh.
Yeah, it did for about a good 3 or 4 months, but when it came back in a much cleaner, a much easier to use format than what they've ever used.
Oh, wow. So, I thought they were just gone. I didn't know they came back.
Hmm. Oh, boy, did they ever.
Okay.
So, yeah, go check them out at theundermindjournal.com. That is a huge website. The only other website that's out there right now that associates themselves with Trade Skill Master is WoW Auction. That's without the A. So go to wowauction.com and you'll be able to see good graphs over there. They don't show the pets, but they will show everything else within that website.
Okay.
The Undermine Journal shows the pets. All right, Reckles. Have at it.
Rage quit. No, I agree. I started with Auctioneer.
Yeah, so did I.
And at the time, it was kind of, you know, do you go with Auctioneer or do you go with Auctionator? Those were kind of the two staples, and you had to decide between one or the other if you wanted to make gold, because the base auction house window has four main problems, in that you can't post multiple stacks really easily, it has bad sorting, and two others that I can't remember, but I have an actual list that I have made. It has better filters.
Why we hate
and
the base UI, yeah.
It does have better sorting and groups that no other... The groups that it has in, like, armor and consumables and all that, though no other add-on has those groups, which is kind of interesting to me that no other auction house window has those groups set up.
Right.
So, but what I do think is that people give TradeSkillMaster a lot of bad rap for being confusing and
right.
a big mamma jamma add-on, and it is in that it takes up some memory, but that's mainly that it is kind of a full profession and mailing and auction mm-hmm. house UI replacement. I mean, you have you don't need postal anymore. You don't need so it automatically takes care of all of your mailing and stuff. It auto loops
yep.
everything. You have you click one button and it crafts everything profitable for you. Auctionator doesn't do that, and there are two other add-ons that it replaces with that.
Right.
You go and after 15 minutes setup, if we do it right, it can, you just go to the auction house and scroll your mouse wheel and it posts everything that you just crafted with one click or two clicks of a button. And so essentially two clicks of a button and a scroll of the mouse wheel, and in 5 minutes you just crafted and posted absolutely everything from your professions that you can make. So that's amazing. That's why TSM is great. It's can seem complicated, but that's why you can make it as complicated as you want, and a lot of gold mm-hmm. makers out there make complicated versions. But you can make easy versions if you want to make easy groups and operations of it. One of the reasons why it seems complicated is because it's written by programmers who think in kind of programming language. So they use words like operations and groups and all
right.
that, rather than, like, I don't know what an easier word would be, but someone should come up with an easier word, but a more layman's term for everything. But it works really well. It's about as simple as you can get for how amazing of a software it is. And really, I recommend new users start using it. Just because of the time you can save. If you want to make gold, just download TradeSkillMaster, get an easy to use setup for it.
Mm-hmm.
It'll create all the groups for you in one click of a button. You don't have to do anything. And You're good to go. And you can use Auctioneer and Auctionator too. It's not mutually exclusive, or it is a mutually exclusive. I always get those confused. But what do you think of that?
Go ahead, Ava.
In the same thing, I started with Auctioneer because I started before Auctionator came out. And Auctioneer was the thing that everyone used. But then as I discovered Auctioneer and some of the things it allowed me to do easier, I made the switch. TSM is both a yes and no. I'm like in between both you guys. I would never specifically recommend, like, my mother to install and use TSM. You all know mm-hmm. she's an avid gamer. She's got two servers full of level 100s. She does a lot of auctioning, but she's not really good with the technical. You know, aside of me going to set it up for her, she wouldn't really get the gist of it. That being said, for most people that game, they can get the basic gist of it. You can set up the very basics of it pretty easily. If I could do it, you know, anybody can do it. That kind of thing. Because, I mean, while I'm pretty good with technical, I'm not a rocket scientist. You know, I set up my basic groups for my pets, and I learned how to twink it a little. And I did it pretty quickly using the options or tools available on the web to do it. So, you know, don't be afraid of it. Go ahead and download it. You know, play with certain pieces of it. I, by all means, do not use all the pieces of it. I don't use the crafting pieces of it probably near as much as I should. But crafting, I could not live without the mailing, period.
Crafting and mailing is good on it, definitely.
Yeah.
If you wish to learn how to use TSM our way, go to yourwowmoney.com/vids, V-I-D-S, and we will show you how to set up a Trade Skill Master. Because me and Ruckles made a video.
Yay!
But yeah, no, I'm kind of in between it there too. I'm in the still in the process of learning it, but I'm doing like a bunch of other projects and stuff. And how you post kind of goes into the next question, because here they're asking about salvage crates. And this is Salmacus, or Sal.
Okay, I've got another question, something that we've been talking about in the chat room. Actually, guys, there's been a lot of good tips and tricks being talked about in the chat room this time. And if you're really interested in gold making on Airy Peak, I would actually recommend going to our YouTube channel and watching this so you can see the chat room roll by. Really good discussion has been happening. And one thing we've been talking about in the mm-hmm. chat room is the greens that come out of the salvage crates. You know, if you have the salvage yard and you get all these crates, you just get just bags and bags and bags mm-hmm. and bags of what we call junk, right? A lot of it is like greens, like gear and stuff. A lot of it's old stuff. A lot of it's new stuff. I got a blue the other day, actually. What do you do with these things?
Well, I do take a chance on the auction house. And by the way, purples drop from them, too.
Wow.
And it's something to, it's very rare.
Yeah, I've never seen one. I've done a ton of those.
Yeah, I've never seen a purple yet.
I've only seen one. And that's what I'm saying. It's very rare. If you see them, take a chance, put them in the auction house. Depending on how your patience is, you can put them in for as number of times as what you want.
Mm-hmm.
And today I will say that I have made about, let me click on auctions. I will say that I've made about close to 200 gold just on those greens that I posted today.
And what do you use as criteria to list? Just history, or like, you know, leather usually sells for this much, leather chest, or like, what do you arbitrarily pick a number, or what? What do you use? I mean, I don't want to steal too much of your magic. You know what I'm saying? I know, you know. But
no, it's really a couple of things. If there's a history to it, then I will tend to use that history.
Okay.
But I will give you a little bit of a math thing, because I'm looking at a certain problem here within Airy Peak and people that are not getting this.
Ooh,
if you're
okay.
If you're posting something that is bind on equip, okay, look at the price of the vendor, basically look at the vendor price, then add that with the deposit price.
The deposit, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then I would say add about 10% for profit. I tried posting a blue, an item level 300. People looked at the vendor price mostly, but they only posted it for 80 silver over the vendor price.
Okay.
The deposit price was about almost 2 gold.
You're losing gold.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You're not losing gold, but you're missing out on
any profit.
A big profit than what you would be making it. So
it's a good tip. It's a good tip.
Just be aware. But on the stuff that has sold, 25, basically I'm putting it at about vendor price plus the estimated deposit plus about another 5 to 10%, and I have made close to 200 gold just sitting here. All right, so what do you guys think about the big crates of salvage?
I don't have your patience. No, joking aside, seriously, I don't. I vendor a vast majority. I really, really do. I tried putting them up for a long, long time, going back and forth. I'd sell off half the inventory after it came back the first time and only post certain things back up. Really, it has to be something that just really sticks out as expensive. And even that, I am the worst. I'm going to be like, I'm undercutting the highest price out here by half just because I want to get rid of this thing, but I don't want to vendor it.
I understand. It is just, it is a matter of patience.
I'm the person that transmog people hate, because I'll take something they're trying to sell for a K, and if I've got it and I just want to get rid of it, I'm going to post it up for 500 gold. Please buy it off me so that you can reset your market and keep going, because chances are I probably won't get another one of those items anywhere in the near future.
What do you think, Reckles? What do you think about all these greens and these blues that you're getting out of these salvage crates?
I like it. I think it's something we've been talking about on the show for a while. It's kind of a bane to the dungeon grinder's existence, in that a lot more of these super, since it seems to be random what you get out of the salvage crates, like a lot of the really hard to get things from dungeons that people didn't farm have been dropping more often. What I do is, if I get something that that I don't have in, so I have my sniper list that we've talked about before. I have a full list of everything, all of the MOG pieces that actually sell.
Right.
And the auction operation is set up to post at a certain range from, 50% to 120% or whatever. And I post those up for, whatever they're going at. And it just posts them automatically. I mail them over to my auctioning tune. And so it kind of just does it automatically. Like, I don't worry about it. If I get anything worthwhile, I just mail it over and post it, and it's a set it and forget it. Like, it just goes into my transmog posting rotation. I don't I don't worry. It's just free gold. So I don't really, it's not a hassle for me like it is with, Hava, because I already have a bunch of things that I'm posting.
Right.
If I don't have it on my list already and it's a good transmog piece, then I will just go into the items list in either that list or a separate list that I have for transmog, and I'll just manually add it, and my list gets bigger. And that's it.
Well, I don't have a big problem with greens there anymore, because there's not a whole lot of greens dropping out of these salvage crates, so I think we're good there. But the last thing was really the biggest news this week, and it's been on quite a few podcasts already. So here we go with gold tokens.
Mm-hmm. The big thing I really want to ask is your opinion about the thing that was announced. It was announced officially, I believe, today, where people are going to be able to buy or trade gold for game time.
Yeah,
which is like legitimizing gold.
What's
selling
that
basically
all about?
I think what Blizzard's trying to do is they're trying to take out these gold sellers and just take them to school, and I do love that.
Yes.
What I tend to think is it's really going to depend on a couple things. One, how much cash are we going to shell out for these game tokens? And the other thing is how much demand is going to be there for these people in these different realms. So for Airy Peak, it's going to be very interesting to see how Airy Peak's going to react to, one, this news, and two, you know, how much are the prices going to be? And I did see one of the posts following up to that on somebody, I forget who it was there on Twitter, but they were hypothesizing that could it be 50K gold for one of these game tokens?
And the game token's 1 month of gaming or what? Like,
yeah, there are 30 days of gaming. Okay. So, and I was looking on the World of Warcraft site. For 30 days, it was $14.99. Mm-hmm. So 50K, I don't quite see it that high.
Okay.
I do tend to think that maybe it's about 40K, maybe 30K. So maybe a stretch to 50K, that it's a possibility. I just don't think I'll see it that high. But we will be talking about this when we do our podcast on Saturday. So I'll be very interested to see on how Hava and Reckles do think about this. So what do you think about this?
Love it. Well, I love it. I absolutely love it.
Do you Okay, no, go ahead.
Okay. So let's talk from a personal perspective. Have I ever considered buying gold? Yes, I have considered it. Have I done it? No, of course not. It's illegal to the game's terms of service. Not going to happen.
Right.
But if I had the times of my life that I've had excess pot money in hand, that I could go buy game time and sell it for, like you said, they're going to legitimize the amounts, that they're going to set a base standard. It's not going to be economy-based. Now, they said regionally-based, so I'm wondering, right, Earthen Ring being East Coast, Airy Peak being West Coast, are we going to see a difference in the prices there? I hope not. If there are, I'm going to make use of it. I'm going to be buying and selling pets on whichever server that the gold, that the game time is the cheapest, because in times of hardship, like things kind of are for me right now, extra $15 I'm not shilling out for game time is, you know, McDonald's for me and the kids one night, or, you know, quite a bit of gas right now since gas prices are down.
Right.
You know? I have the means to make the money in, make the gold in game to chill out for the game token. Like you mentioned, however, the price is going to be the limiting factor. If they set it at 100K, I'm probably not going to be doing that because you know how hard I have to hold on to 100K, much less make 100K in a single month's time. 50K, yeah, that would be much more doable. But do I think that reasonably mimics the current gold market? No, that's expensive. And, you know, if they're going to institute this in the game, they need to take a look at the illegal source of gold we have right now and what the current market is and at least set it reasonable. If not, they're gouging their players. They're taking advantage of their players. And I like to believe that Blizzard's better than that. So I hope it's a reasonable trade as it is, you know, set to the current black market money. But at the same time, you know, if I can make it, I will be making use of it. And in times of prosperity for me and my household, I may be taking advantage of it on the flip side. I love it.
What are your thoughts on this, Reckles?
So I have a Google alert. I don't know if y'all know what Google alerts are, but it automatically sends you an email whenever anywhere on the internet something pops up. And I have a Google alert set up for WTB Gold. Just to see if anyone's mentioned my site or my YouTube channel. Well, something that pops up pretty regularly with that is gold selling sites. So I have a pretty good idea of what the market is for this. And it's pretty... Currently, the prices for EU gold are about 0.15 to 0.3 euros, and on the US side it's about 0.3 to 0.5 dollars per 1,000 gold. So the conversion rate would be, you know, one of these would sell, you know, if you bought one of these and you...
$15, what, 30K?
Yeah, you'd get...
At 0.5, yeah.
Yeah.
0.5, so 50 cents by $15 is, you know, times 1,000, that'd be 30,000. That's very doable. And that's the high end. You said the low end of gold prices was 0.3?
Right.
That's just insane. So, I love it. If they go reasonable, I mean, they could even go up to 50. I think at 50K... most people would still take advantage of it. I don't figure that's gouging, you know?
And I would agree with that. I would say...
If they price it at 100, it ain't gonna fly.
Right.
Most people don't make 100K gold in a month.
Well, see, for Blizzard...
Question is do they want most people to make use of it? They're selling the same amount of gold time either way. Game time.
Right. And if they set the prices about $15, or we'll use the American currency, just because we're Americans. Yeah, about 50K. I could see that.
30 to 50, yeah.
30 to 50 right there.
And one of the interesting things that is going to happen here is over the years, the gap between the rich and the poor in the World of Warcraft economy has become greater than even the most corrupt countries in the world. And so this, essentially, the wealthy people are going to be giving their gold to the poor people. And so you're going to get kind of a rise of the middle class. Right. You're going to be creating a middle class, because right now you have this super, super wealthy group, and then you have the average people who have about 30K, and then there's kind of no one in the middle. There's a couple of people who have 100K, but then like the rest of the people have like 8 million gold. So it's like you have 3K, bunch of people with 30K, and then a bunch of people with 8 million gold. So this is going to be all those people with millions and millions of gold saying like, well, I want a bunch of free game time, so sure, let's trade in all this gold that I don't have anything to do with, really.
Mm-hmm.
So sure. So they're going to be giving all this gold away and, you know, spreading it out over a couple, you know, 50 people. And so you're going to have this evening out of the economy. It's going to be really cool. I'm excited to see what it's going to do to the economy.
I am being very patient. I have a patient enthusiasm for this.
Oh, boy. Guess what Hava just got?
Oh, what did you do?
Because, you know, we've been kind of farting around in-game. I went and did some fishing and fished up some pickled eel, or fished up some abyssal gulper eel and made some pickled eel. And guess what Hava got while cooking said pickled eel?
Oh, what did you get?
Tweet, tweet. A little leftovers.
Nice.
Hello, money. Hello, money. Speaking of which, hello, money calling.
Hello.
Hello.
Ring, ring. Very, very nice.
So let's go see. Let's go. I'm going to take him to the auction house.
Oh, let's go see.
And if you want to read the thing I was just talking about, Google World of Warcraft Gold Survey or World of Warcraft Wealth Survey. Both of those should pop up. But those were done. They had like 10,000 people submit a whole bunch of things about their demographics and their gold-making stuff. And it was really, really cool. It was the biggest gold-making survey done by the Golden Crusade, a really cool guy. So, check that out.
Yay, and there's now a little leftovers on the Earthen Ring Auction House for 20K. That is 2K less than the current auction.
I see it. 20K right there. Very nice. Well, I think that does it. Special thanks goes out to the Convert to Ray, or I'm sorry, the Converted Podcast.
Yes, yes.
For allowing us to do the whole audio thing, and like
it was great to talk to them, even in tandem.
I kind of sorta. You can find them at theconverted.com or convertedpodcast.com. I'm sorry, convertedpodcast.com. Yes.
All right, people, it's time to end the podcast now. So, how can the players get a hold of you?
Just like last week.
Woohoo! You can find the show live on mobile.alphageekradio.com and on the TuneIn app.
And you can find us live on yourwowmoney.com/live at 2:30 p.m. on Saturdays.
And if you don't want to listen to us live, you can hear us on Stitcher, iTunes, and any other podcast apps.
If you're in the website, you can use the speak pipe on the right-hand side of the page and leave us a voice message.
Or you can find us on Twitter at Your Wow Money, Facebook at Your Wow Money Cast, and on LinkedIn.com/in/YourWowMoney, if I can get those words out of my mouth.
You can find me on twitch.tv/LadyHalva for the Better Late Than Never rate times, 8:30 to 11:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Monday and Thursday, on Twitter at LadyHalva, and email me, LadyHalva@YourWowMoney.com.
Let's see if he remembers his email, Ed. Go for it, Rickles.
You can find me on YouTube at youtube.com/WTB Gold Wow. My blog is WTBGold.blogspot.com, and you can find me on Twitter at Ryan A. Eccles. That's Eckles.
And he forgot his email address. In fact, he just took it out of Drive. And you can find me on YouTube.com/KerosineKid. I am at Caro_Gold on Twitter. You can find me in game at Caro#1397, or you can email me Caro@YourWowMoney.com. Well done. That was a lot of stuff to go through. And we'll keep the blogs for next week. But the Gold Queen is back. She's been posting. So welcome back, my dear. We may talk about you there next week. And I think it's just recording only this week. I apologize if you were trying to listen to us there on Alpha Geek Radio, but hopefully we'll get things figured out for next week. It's my bad. Anyway, I apologize for that. But anyway, we'll see you guys next week, so that way you guys can get your gold on, because we know that gold looks good on you. Bye-bye.
This podcast recorded before a live internet audience. To learn how to listen and watch live, visit TuneIn.AlphaGeekRadio.com.